The second principle has to do with how people make decisions. And economists in general propose that people make decisions based on costs and benefits. And you simply should take an action when the benefits of taking that action outweigh the cost of taking that action. And again, it's a very simple principle, but when you apply it, it doesn't seem as simple. So let's try to apply it without again using an example. Say this is the only course you're taking. It's a course in macroeconomics. But perhaps that's the case. But let's assume that you are taking more than one. Let's say you're taking this course, and then you're also taking a course in astronomy. It could be another course, but let's assume that it's a course in astronomy. So every week you have to decide to allocate your time between answering problems of economics versus answering problems in astronomy. If these are the only two courses you have, then every time you spend an hour or 2 hours studying for economics, the opportunity costs are the problems that you're not going to be able to answer for the other class, astronomy. So let's be a little more specific. Say that you have you're able to calculate exactly how many minutes it takes you to answer a question in each class. And this is a table we have right here. These are the minutes it takes you to answer questions in economics and questions in astronomy. So the first, if you answer an economics question, the first problem will take you 5 minutes to answer. The second problem will take you 10 minutes. The third problem will take you 15 minutes. And the fourth problem will take you 20 minutes. Now, clearly, it takes a different time to answer in problems because we're going to make the simple assumption, which is like a realistic assumption, is that you're probably going to start with the easy problems, you answer those first, and then you move to the hard problems, right? So not all problems are the same. It's going to take you a different amount of time. And probably the hard problems, which are the ones that you see at the end, in most quizzes or assignments, are going to take you more time to answer than the first problems you do. Not every problem is not the same. And then astronomy, we're going to keep that general idea, but we're going to say that it generally takes you longer, right? So it takes you 10 minutes to answer the first problem, 15 minutes to answer the second problem, 20 to answer the third, and 25 to answer the fourth one. Right? We're going to say that, we're going to assume that astronomy, it's a hypothetical example, we're going to assume that astronomy is harder than economics. I don't necessarily think that's the case, but let's just, for the sake of the example, let's say that. Now, let's say that you're deciding right now which problem to answer next. You have a choice. You can spend your next few minutes answering astronomy, or you can answer economics. And the question is, with the information I'm giving you here, which one will be the best decision for you, to answer an astronomy problem or to answer an economics problem? Right? If you answer the astronomy problems, the opportunity cost of answering those problems will be the economics problems you won't be able to answer, and if you answer an economics problem, the opportunity cost of that will be the astronomy problems you won't be able to answer. So I want you to take a moment and think about that problem. You have the table. What would be the best economic decision that you should do? Should you answer an economic problem, or should you answer an astronomy problem? Okay, so what's the answer? Well, I think the answer is you can't answer. Right? Because you don't have all the information. Let me explain to you why. A lot of you will actually simply say, well, you're a lot better at answering astronomy. I mean, answering economics in general, it takes you about, on average, it takes you about 13 minutes to answer an economic problem. And on average, it takes you a lot more to answer an astronomy problem. So perhaps a lot of you said that you should answer an economics problem because it takes you less, right? So you give up less, right? But actually, that's not the case, because each problem takes you different time. And if you don't know where you are right now, right? That the principles say that is the value and the cost and the benefits of your next action, not the average action, right? So suppose that at the moment, you had actually already answered three problems in economics, and you have not answered any problems in astronomy. And at that moment, you have to make a decision of what to do. Well, clearly, if you answer one more problem in economics, it will cost you 20, because that will be the fourth. But if you answer another problem in astronomy, it will cost you 10. So clearly, if you had already answered three problems in economics, your best decision will be to answer a question in astronomy, because it's actually cheaper. So what I'm getting here is that to make a decision as to the next action, what you consider is the next action, right? Which economists call the marginal action, right? The small change. You never make a decision based on the average cost, but you make a decision based on the additional cost or the marginal cost. If you're deciding whether to hire another employee, you don't make a decision based on the average cost of all your employees, but you make a decision on the additional costs that additional employee will actually bring to your operation and the additional benefits that employee will bring to the operation. The same way that when you're trying to decide which question to answer, which problem to answer from each class, you base on the additional time that it will take you to answer that question versus not answering that question. Okay? Now, let's take the same approach and apply it to something else, just to kind of prove that it works in all areas of life. Let's say football, American football, right? So usually a quarterback has two options. He can either pass the ball or he can even run the ball, right? And let's say that on average, passing the ball, and this is actually the case, on average, passing the ball gives you more yards, advance the team more than running the ball. Does that mean that the quarterback is going to pass the ball all the time? Well, if you have any knowledge about a football, or you have seen any football game, you know that's not the case. A quarterback actually passes the ball sometimes and sometimes run the ball. So how come that if they're on average passing the ball gets you more yards, advances the team more, how come they don't pass the ball all the time? Well, I guess you know the answer already. If they pass the ball all the time, the opposing team will know that they're passing the ball and they will guard according to that. Because the decision is not based on average, but the quarterback say, given the fact that I have done this in the past, the next movement, this is the best one. And in the next movement, a running might actually give you more than a passing if you have actually passed for the previous 10 times. Right? Because the decision the quarterback makes is not based on the average he had up to that point, but it's based on what he or she thinks the next play is going to give him. And the next play, sometimes the run will give him more than the passing, even though on average the passing gives more. Right? So, and this is a very important thing that, you know, probably we all apply, but we sometimes don't spend time to think about it. A quarterback knows this. He doesn't know anything about economics. Well, he's like a pool player playing pool very well without any knowledge of physics, right? The quarterback also knows that the average passing is more in yards, but he still decides to run the ball sometimes because it's really the next play what determines what the best outcome is. So the benefits, the principles say that the net marginal benefits, you only make a decision when the net marginal benefits of an action outweigh the cost, right? When the marginal benefits of an action outweigh the marginal cost. Again, it's a very simple principle and in theory, but when you apply it, it's a little more difficult. You'll have questions like this one to practice it this week.
Produced by OCE Atlas Digital Media at the University of Illinois, Urbana-Champaign.